All right, round number seven. We are facing Jarvis Yu. Jarvis and I have actually been working together recently on deck, so this is unfortunate. I know that Jarvis is on Breach with Tinker in it. Doesn't feel good. Jarvis is actually the person that told me that I should, or inspired me at least, to play 3 Yixla Jailer. Jarvis is actually playing 4 Yixla Jailers today. Yeah. One on top, one on the bottom for Jarvis. Top on the end step. Well, that's good. What secrets do you hold, Jarvis? Double pyro. And Jarvis is threatening a kill next turn as well. So, if we allow this to resolve, Jarvis actually has an extra counter. So, I just want to think this through. So, let's say we let this resolve. Jarvis has to sack it for black. Or, well, let's say this resolves. Jarvis sacrifices... I'm going to let it resolve. I think it's right to let it resolve here. And Jarvis would agree. So we know that the demonic tutor is gone. Another force is good. Jarvis is passing. We'll top again. Part of me thinks I'm supposed to get flustered with this, probably. This is an interesting game. Right now, I think my plan is probably to PO on Jarvis's end step. But Jarvis might try to kill me this turn, so that could obviously change. The plan would be to tap Academy and Underground Sea, target three artifacts. Don't tap top, just accept that top is going to. That the PO is probably not going to resolve. There's no reason to tap Mana Vault. I'm not expecting this to resolve, so once again, I am not tapping top. Force pitch force. That's interesting. We know that there's a mystical. Ooh, that was not the card I thought was on top. Oh, I thought that was a mystical. Oh. I feel like I'm going to get blown out here. That was good. And Jarvis is conceded. Okay. That was an intense game. I can't believe that I messed up. I thought for sure that there was a mystical on top. All right, so we are bringing in Soul Guide Lantern and two Fluster. What turn was that? Turn five. For being five turns, that game felt like an eternity. Like, my heart is racing right now. All right, let's try this. All right. Force and Fluster. I'm trying to figure out if I should be trying to make them pitch two counters here. They put double on top with their preordain, so they drew one of them. I think I'm going to burn the Lotus. All right, let's get two counters. Ooh, Jarvis let her resolve. Don't need Emerald. We can just pass here. I wonder if the other is a red source for the Dreadhorde. Nope. Yikes. All mana, all the time. Think I'm going to take Opal. any Underworld breach at this point just becomes insane for us because they can't fluster or pyro it, and we're pretty far ahead in terms of resources. I like this ponder draw. Excuse me. It's worth noting that there's no red for Pyro or Dreadhorde. We're going to shuffle that. We have a lot of mana, so we're at the point where we are bullying this Flusterstorm a little bit. We know three of the four in Jarvis's hand. I do like these. Oh, that was dumb. I just denied myself a mana. That was so stupid. Ugh. Jarvis is probably thinking to himself right now that I just punted. Force Pitch Tinker. Force Pitch. I'm gonna pitch Force. So if Jarvis's last card in hand is a Fluster, I will win the Flusterstorm battle because I have more mana. And the last card was a Fluster. Jarvis was a little bit color screwed this game, and we took advantage of it. So that puts us at 6-1. Next round is the last round of Swiss. Hopefully we get there, but, you know, this has been a terrific event so far. Good games, Jarvis. And, Hey, Brian Cook here. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like and subscribe, but also follow the social media channels down below. If you want to support this content directly, I would recommend going to theepicstorm.com/shop. And if you need a little bit of assistance with the Epic Storm to get to that next level, I would recommend going to theepicstorm.com/tutoring. Don't worry, there's more great content coming right up.